哈利路亚，各位弟兄姐妹，大家晚安。
Hallelujah, good evening, brothers and sisters.
愿主耶稣的恩惠与我们众人同在。
May the grace of our Lord Jesus be with all of us.
在今天的晚上，我们要继续的从耶利米书当中来做学习。
Tonight, we will continue to learn from the book of Jeremiah.
我们请翻到耶利米书的第十四章。
Let us turn to Jeremiah chapter 14.
耶利米书第十四章。
Jeremiah chapter 14.
十四章的第一节。
Verse 1.
神论到干旱之灾的话临到耶利米，第二节。
2.
犹大悲哀，城门衰败，众人披上黑衣，坐在地上。耶路撒冷的哀声上达，第三节。
3.
他们的贵胄打发家童打水，他们来到水池，见没有水，就拿着空器皿，蒙羞惭愧，抱头而回，请念。
Jeremiah chapter 14 verses 1 to 3. 1. The word of the Lord that came to Jeremiah concerning the droughts. 2. Judah mourns and her gates languish. They mourn for the land, and the cry of Jerusalem has gone up. 3. Their nobles have sent their lads for water. They went to the cisterns and found no water. They returned with their vessels empty. They were ashamed and confounded and covered their heads.
在这里谈到的是耶利米年代这耶路撒冷所遇到的事情。
Here it talks about something that happened in Jerusalem during the time of Jeremiah.
我们在之前有谈到耶利米书其实是一卷非常悲哀的书。
Previously, we mentioned that the book of Jeremiah is actually a very tragic book.
耶利米先知被称之为流泪的先知。
And the prophet Jeremiah is called the weeping prophet.
因为耶利米所处的年代已经是犹大国的末了，犹大国的尾声。
Because the time of the prophet Jeremiah was already towards the end of the kingdom of Judah.
那耶利米先知奉差遣出来传警告，但是却看不到太多的盼望。
And even though Jeremiah was called by God and became a prophet, but he did not see much hope.
他知道百姓接下来要面对什么。
And he knows what the people will face.
他知道国家会发生什么事。
And he knows what will happen to their nation.
他知道灾祸将要临到众人的身上。
And they know that calamity will come upon the people.
他传警告，他担心，他忧虑，他哭泣。
He preached the warning, he was worried, he was in anguish, and he cared for the people.
但是却看不到任何的改变，也不知道怎么样使百姓回头。
But he could not see any change, and he did not know how to turn the people back.
所以耶利米耶利米先知是一个悲伤的先知。
So the prophet Jeremiah is a prophet who was very sad.
他爱他的国家。
He loves his country.
但是却知道他的国家将近要毁灭。
But he knows that his country is about to be destroyed.
他爱神的百姓。
He loves the people of God.
但是却看不到百姓回转重新信仰复兴的机会。
But he could not see the people turn back and restore their faith.
所以到最后，耶利米书成为他流泪的书信，成为他悲伤的泉源。
So in the end, the book of Jeremiah becomes a book of his weeping, a source of his lament.
所以耶利米书告诉我们，犹大要面对灾祸，犹大要面临毁灭。
And the book of Jeremiah tells us that Judah will face disaster, Judah will face destruction.
为什么神的国度，为什么神的百姓会遭遇这样的灾呢？
Why is it that the kingdom of God, the people of God, will face such an end?
我们就从第十四章当中来做一点的学习跟思考。
From chapter 14, we can learn and ponder about this.
我们来看耶利米书十四章的第十节。
Let's turn to Jeremiah chapter 14, verse 10.
第十节，神对这百姓如此说，这百姓喜爱妄行，不禁止脚步，所以神不悦纳他们，现今要纪念他们的罪孽，追讨他们的罪恶，请念。
Verse 10, Thus says the Lord to this people, Thus they have loved to wander, they have not restrained their feet, therefore the Lord does not accept them, he will remember their iniquity now and punish their sins.
那在这里当谈到犹大国遭灾，百姓被毁灭的原因，在这里讲了几样。
When it talks about the reason why calamity comes upon Judah and the people are going to be destroyed, it mentions several reasons.
在这里首先讲到的是百姓的恶行。
First, it talks about the wicked things that the people have done.
什么样的行为神不喜悦，什么样的表现必会遭灾。
What type of conduct is disliked by God, and what type of behavior did they have to bring this calamity?
在这里，神对百姓说：“你们喜欢妄行，不禁止脚步。”
Here, God says to them, "They love to wander and have not restrained their feet."
所以，百姓的罪是什么？
So, what is the sin of the people?
百姓的罪在于妄行，不禁止脚步。
The sin of the people.Was that they did what they pleased and they did not restrain their feet.
什么叫做妄行？什么叫做不禁止脚步呢？
What does it mean to wander and to not restrain their feet?
就是这些百姓不喜欢听到别人的教训，不喜欢按照规矩来行。
It means that this people did not like listening to teachings of other people. They did not like to act in an orderly fashion.
就是我今天想去哪我就去哪里，我今天想做什么我就做什么。
It means that they say to themselves, today whatever I want to do, wherever I want to go, I will go there and do that.
其实人都不喜欢被别人看管。
And generally, nobody likes to be managed by other people.
我们都希望能够有自由，我们都希望随心所欲来做事。
We all want to have freedom. We want to do things as we please.
像我们在开车的时候。
Just like when we're driving.
你遇到红绿灯，你觉得很烦。
When you face a traffic light, you are very annoyed at the traffic light.
对面就明明没有车，为什么我还要在这里傻等？
Clearly, there are no cars or incoming traffic, but I'm still waiting here.
这个法律真讨厌，这样的规矩真令人厌烦。
This traffic law, this rule here is very annoying.
我喜欢，我希望我想怎么开就怎么开，要开多快我就开多快。
And I wish I can just drive however I want to drive, no matter how fast I want.
我喜欢油门一踩拼命冲，完全不用守任何的交通规则。
I want to just step down on the press down on the pedal and drive as fast as I want and have no consequences.
说这样的自由你喜欢，我也喜欢。
And this type of freedom, you may like it and I may like it.
因为人都不喜欢被管束，人都不喜欢被限制。
Because nobody likes to be managed and ruled over by other people.
但是我们今天如果真的照我们随心所欲，让我们任意妄行。
But today, if we truly do everything according to what we please ourselves,
路上没有这个没有红绿灯这个路上没有任何的规矩。
And we go on the street, there are no traffic lights, there are no rules.
你油门尽量踩，你可以拼命飙。
You can push down on the pedal and go as fast as you want.
有没有自由？有。有没有开心？也有。
Will you have freedom? Yes. Will you be happy? Yes.
然后就死掉了。
And then you will be dead.
因为你这样子开，别人也这样子开，那没有规矩，大家任意妄行，就是到处都是意外跟车祸。
Because if you drive in this way, someone else will always drive in this way, and there are no rules, and in the end, everybody will die and get hurt.
所以神为他的百姓设下了很多的规矩跟条例。
So God set a lot of laws and rules for his people.
而这些规矩、这些条例、这些律例典章，是要教导他们能够在神面前行得正，能够得神的喜悦。
And these rules, these laws and ordinances that God gave his people are to help them act righteously before God and be pleasing to God.
那使这些百姓蒙着能够配得称为神的儿女，能够得到神给予的福气。
So that this people are worthy to be called the children of God and can receive the blessing of God.
那但是这些百姓怎么说呢？
But what did this people say?
他们说神的律法是何等的繁琐，多么的讨厌啊。
They say that the laws of God are so bothersome, they are so detestable.
那管东管西都没有给我自由。
God wants us to do this and that. He doesn't give us any freedom.
以至于他们后来对神的律法嗤之以鼻。
And in the end, they did not like the laws of God at all.
而任意妄行的结果就是付出代价。
And the consequence of doing whatever they wanted is that they have to pay the price.
所以今天如果你是个不服约束的人。
So today, if you are a person who does not want to be restrained,
你觉得信仰很麻烦，你觉得教会管很多。
You feel that your faith is an annoyance and the church is trying to tell you to do too many things.
你觉得你想怎么过日子，你根本不想要有人管你。
And you feel like you should be able to live your life however you want it. You don't want anybody to tell you what to do.
那你可能就会落到像这些犹大人一样的一样的境况。
Then perhaps you will fall into the same situation as these people of Judah.
因为第十节说百姓他们不禁止自己的脚步。
Because in verse 10 it says that the people have not restrained their feet.
结果就是神不悦纳他们，神不喜欢他们。
And the result is therefore the Lord does not accept them, that the Lord does not like them.
当这些百姓喜爱妄行，
When these people love to wander,
就会走到罪孽的道，最后神要追讨他们的恶。
They will wander to the paths of wickedness, and in the end, God will ask them to give an account.
所以在这里我们看到百姓遭灾，神的选民落在患难之中的第一个原因。
Here we see the first reason why the people of God has this calamity coming upon them.
我们看回来耶利米书的第十四章。
Let's go back to Jeremiah chapter 14.
第十四章的第十三节。
Verse 13.
十三节我就说，嗨，主神啊，那些先知常对他们说，你们必不见刀剑，也不遇饥荒，神要在这地方赐你们长久的平安，请念。
Verse 13, Then I said, Ah, Lord God, behold, the prophets say to them, You shall not see the sword, nor shall you have famine, but I will give you assured peace in this place.
在这里我们看到这些百姓遭灾遇大患难的第二个原因。
Here we see the second reason why the people has calamity facing them.
什么原因呢？就是他们听到了这些先知所说的话，他们就接受相信。
And the reason is that when they heard the words of these prophets, they accepted them.
当然你会觉得说，听到先知的话，相信难道有错吗？
And maybe you'll say, to hear the words of the prophet and believe the prophets, is this wrong?
就好像今天你聚会听到传道的话，难道不对吗？
Just like today, when you go to service and you hear the words of the preacher, is this wrong?
这个应该要是对，但是它不一定永远都是对。
And usually this would be the right thing, but it is not always the case, and it will not always be the case.
因为我们每个人对自己的信仰跟自己的救恩是要自己来负责任的。
Because each of us individually is responsible for our own faith and our own salvation.
所以今天如果你把你信仰的责任担在别人的身上。
So today, if we put the responsibility of our faith onto other people,
你认为你所听到的一定要是对啊，所以听到什么你全部都相信接受。
And you think that whatever you hear must be right, and you accept everything you hear.
然后没有自我思考，没有自己主动学习的用心跟努力。
And you never think and reflect and make your own diligence to try to understand.
那要是我说错了怎么办？
Then what will happen if what I am saying now is wrong?
好，我们来看箴言的第十四章。
Let's turn to Proverbs chapter 14.
箴言的第十四章。
Proverbs chapter 14.
箴言十四章的第十五节。
Proverbs chapter 14, verse 15.
十五节，愚昧人是话都信，通达人步步谨慎，请念。
Proverbs 14:15, the simple believes every word, but the prudent considers well his steps.
当然我们并不是叫大家不要听传道讲的，不要相信传道教导的。
Of course, we're not saying you should try to not listen to preachers and not believe what the preachers are teaching.
但是今天你如果纯粹听，从不想，纯粹聚会，从不学习。
But today, if you are only purely listening and never thinking about what you're listening to, or you go to service, but you never try to learn.
你没有把所听见的去考证，你没有把所听见的去思想。
You never try to verify what you have heard. You never think about the words you are hearing.
那如果假设你所得到的资讯，你所听到的教导是错误的，你要怎么办？
Then what will happen if the words, the information you receive is wrong? What will you do?
因为传道也是人，他有时候也一样会有自己的错误，会有自己的软弱。
Because preachers are people too. Sometimes they will make their own mistakes and be wrong in certain aspects.
所以为什么我们常常鼓励信徒要认真学习，仔细思考，然后要建立自己的这个建立自己的灵修习惯。
And this is why we constantly encourage members to always think and really think and consider the words that we're listening to and be diligent in establishing our own faith.
我们鼓励信徒要多读圣经，才能了解圣经上到底在说什么。
We encourage believers to read the Bible often so that we can know what the Bible is saying.
那其实讲实话，如果就我们就讲道的人来说
Because truthfully speaking, if we're only talking about the sermon speakers,
其实听众懂得越少，我们越好。
Actually, the less the audience knows, the easier it is for us.
因为你什么都不懂，我随便讲你也不知道。
Because if the audience doesn't know anything, I can just say whatever I want.
反正我讲错我讲对，你没有办法能力，你没有办法判断，你没有能力分辨，对讲的人来说压力最小。
And because you have no ability to discern what is right and wrong, I can say whatever I want, whether right or wrong, and there's no pressure.
你根本没有办法分辨，所以你不可能知道或指正我的对错。
Because you have no ability to discern, so you don't know when I'm saying something wrong.
结果就是我讲你就呵呵呵，你什么都不知道啊。
And in the end, whatever I say, you'll just nod your head and you don't really know anything.
但是今天为什么我们鼓励信徒要多读圣经，多学道理？
So why is it that today we encourage believers to diligently study the word and learn the Bible?
因为永生是你的，灵魂是你的，天国是你的，你要努力才能进窄门啊。
Because eternal life is this eternal life is one that you're seeking. The narrow gate is one that you're going through.
所以在这里我们看到这些百姓他们这个先知说什么他们就听什么。
So when we look at the people here, whatever the prophets say, they believe.
结果先知讲错，他们没有办法分辨。先知说谎，他们不能够知道对错。
And in the end, when the prophets say the wrong thing or when the prophets are lying, they are not able to discern what is true and false.
所以在何西阿书的第四章第六节告诉我们。
So in Hosea chapter 4 verse 6, it tells us.
何西阿书四章六节说，我的百姓因为没有知识而灭亡。
It says, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
所以因为无知到最后在无知当中灭亡。
Because they are ignorant, in the end, they are destroyed in their ignorance.
因为无知没有办法判别对错，更不能知道什么是神的旨意。
Because they are ignorant, they are not able to discern between right and wrong and know what is the will of God.
所以今天我们一定要记住一件事情。
So today we have to remember one thing.
一个人的无知是一种遗憾，而不是一个犯错的理由。
A person's ignorance is a regret, and it is not an excuse to commit mistakes.
更不要以为我只要讲一句 I don't know, 我不知道啊，好像就能够无罪脱身。
And don't think, you can just say, I didn't know, and you can be free of all guilt.
我们刚讲说无知是一种遗憾。
And we mentioned earlier that ignorance is a type of regret.
说犯了罪得罪神，你后来才发现人生当中就有了遗憾。
That because of your ignorance, you sinned against God, and later when you find out it was because of your ignorance, you have this regret in your life.
你在神面前永远都有一个缺陷，都有一个遗憾的。
And when you stand before God, you will forever have this regret, this missing piece.
所以无知是一个悲哀，无知是一个遗憾，但无知从来不会是一个脱罪的理由。
So ignorance is a tragedy. Ignorance is a regret, but ignorance is never an excuse to be free from guilt.
所以在这里我们看到这些百姓，他们没有办法分辨这些先知所说的话。
So here we see that these people are not able to discern what the prophets are saying.
在这里先知告诉他们什么
And what are the prophets telling them here?
先知跟他们讲说先知告诉他们说你会有平安不会有饥荒神会赐给你平安
The prophets are telling them that you will have peace there will be no famine God will give you peace
在这里百姓听了哈哈笑心里非常高兴有平安啊有平安
And when the people heard this they just laugh with joy andThey have peace in their hearts, thinking that there is peace.
但是有平安吗？没有平安啊。
But did they get peace? They did not.
他们遇见刀剑，遭遇饥荒，没有平安。
They faced the sword and famine, and they had no peace.
但是这些百姓听到先知所讲的话，他们就心中欢喜了。
But when these people heard what the prophets are saying,They rejoice in their heart.
因为这些先知所说的话是讨了他们的欢心，是他们耳朵所想听见的。
Because what the prophets are saying were very pleasing to them. They were exactly what their ears wanted to hear.
人都喜欢听好话。
Everybody likes to hear good news.
你做了一些事情，大家都说你好棒，你好优秀，做得真好。
When you do something, everybody likes to hear other people praising you, saying, you did such a great job, this is so good.
你听了就好高兴啊，非常非常非常，你就好高兴，你觉得对方讲你好的都是好人啊。
And when you hear this, you're so happy inside, and you feel that everyone who is saying this to you is a good person.
但是如果有人告诉你，你这个做的有点问题，这个地方没有做好。
But if someone says to you,could have done something better in this area, or you didn't do this part that well.
常常啊，听了以后心里就不舒服啊。
And a lot of times when you hear this, you start to feel bad inside.
人都不喜欢听到批评的声音。
Because we don't like to hear any sort of criticism.
所以如果有人说你做得不好，你就跟他讲，要不然你来做啊。
So if someone says to you, you didn't do a great job, and then you would immediately say, well, then you do it.
如果有人说你这个地方可以再进步一点，你就说你一定是嫉妒我。
And if someone says to you, you can improve in this area, and then immediately you respond, oh, you must be jealous of me.
啊，因为常常人都喜欢听好话，而不喜欢别人啊，别人的责备，或者是给予太多的建议。
Because we often only like to hear praise, we don't like to hear any advice or criticism.
好，我们来看以赛亚书的三十章。
Let's turn to Isaiah chapter 30.
以赛亚书的第三十章。
Isaiah chapter 30.
三十章的第九节。
Verse 9.
第九节。因为他们是悖逆的百姓，说谎的儿女，不肯听从神训诲的儿女。第十节。
10.
他们对先见说，不要望见不吉利的事，对先知说，不要向我们说正直的话，要向我们说柔和的话，言虚幻的事。第十一节。
11.
你们要偏离啊，离弃正道，偏离直路，不要在我们面前再提说以色列的圣者，请念。
Verses 9 to 11, that this is a rebellious people, lying children, children who will not hear the law of the Lord. 10, who say to the seers, do not see, and to the prophets, do not prophesy to us right things, speak to us smooth things, prophesy deceits. 11, get out of the way, turn aside from the path, cause the Holy One of Israel to cease from before us.
在这里啊，神在讲到这些百姓。
Here, God is talking about this people.
其实如果看这一段的话，真的是一件非常令人悲哀的事。
And if we just look at this passage, we see this is a very tragic thing.
神的百姓有神的先知。
The people of God have the prophets of God.
神的百姓有神的旨意。
The people of God also have the will of God.
但是他们却对先知说，你不要告诉我们，我们不想听的。
But they tell the prophets, don't tell us the things we don't want to hear.
你讲那个我喜欢的，讲那个让我高兴的，这样子我才要支持你，我才会喜欢你。
Only tell me the things I want to hear, the things that are good. Only then will I support you and help you.
这不是一件很悲哀的事吗？
Isn't this a very tragic thing?
他们明明知道这些都是假话跟谎话，但是他们宁愿选择谎话让自己开心。
They clearly know that these things they're asking for were all lies and deceit, but they willingly want to receive these things.
因为真话太痛苦，实话很伤人。
Because the truth, the right things are too hurtful for them to hear.
这个讲到真话就扎心啊！讲到真话，我就必须要悔改，我必须要改变啊。
When the prophets speak the truth, then their hearts are pierced, and they have to repent.
但是我不想扎心，也不要悔改。
But they don't want their hearts pierced, and they don't want to repent.
所以就告诉先知说，你不要再讲我不喜欢听的话了。
So they tell the prophets, "Don't say these things I don't want to hear."
你可能会觉得这样子的人非常莫名其妙。
You might feel that this type of people are just strange.
但是有没有这样子的人很多。
But do these people exist? They do, and in great number.
我们来看列王记上的二十二章。
Let's turn to 1 Kings chapter 22.
列王记上的二十二章。
1 Kings chapter 22.
二十二章的第七节。
Verse 7.
第七节
,7.
约沙法说，这里不是还有神的先知，我们可以求告他吗？第八节
,8.
以色列王对约沙法说，还有一个人是因拉的儿子米该亚，我们可以托他求问神，只是我恨他，因为他指着我说的预言不说吉言，单说凶言，请念。
Verses 7 and 8. And Jehoshaphat said, Is there not still a prophet of the Lord here that we may inquire of him? 8. So the king of Israel said to Jehoshaphat, There is still one man, Micaiah, the son of Imlah, by whom we may inquire of the Lord. But I hate him, because he does not prophesy good concerning me, but evil.
在这里我们看到了圣经上真的真的有这样子的人啊。
So we see in the Bible, this type of people truly exist.
他明明知道有先知，他明明知道这个先知能够有神的旨意。
They know in fact that there is a prophet of God, and this prophet of God has the will of God.
啊，但是这里亚哈王说，我就是不喜欢他。
But King Herod said, Ahab said here that I hate him.
啊，他说啊，每次讲我都讲我很坏。
Because every time he prophesies concerning evil.
啊，为什么讲你很坏？啊，因为你真的很坏呀。
But why does he say you're evil? Because you truly are evil.
啊，但是啊，这个亚哈就不喜欢啊，我很坏是我的事啊，你要讲我很好才可以。
But Ahab does not like this. He says, if I'm evil, that's my problem. You need to tell me good things.
啊，所以他说，我就是不喜欢这样的先知啊，我恨他。
And he says he doesn't like this type of prophet. He says, I hate him.
啊，所以弟兄姐妹，我们今天要问问自己。
So brothers and sisters, we have to ask ourselves.
啊，你有没有恨先知啊？
Have you hated prophets?
啊，先知讲的话你不喜欢啊，这个圣经教的道理你听了厌烦。
When a prophet say things you don't like hearing, or the Bible tells you things that you are annoyed at.
啊，所以你就说啊，可是啊，我恨这个传道啊。
And then you'll say, but I hate this preacher.
啊，因为他啊，每次都指着我说凶言。
Because every time he speaks evil of me.
我恨这本圣经啊。
And I hate this Bible.
啊，因为啊，每次都责备我是错的。
Because it always rebukes me, saying I did something wrong.
啊，我恨这个神啊。
And I hate this God.
啊，因为他管我很多啊，让我觉得我啊，让我觉得啊，我都啊，我都没有办法达到他的要求。
Because he keeps setting these rules over me and makes me feel that I could never meet his expectation.
啊，说你恨谁呀？
So who do you hate?
哦，这里说啊，亚哈知道先知从神来有讯息，但是他就是不喜欢听啊，听到这些责备的话。
Here it tells us that Ahab knows that this prophet is from God and has a message from God, but he does not want to listen.
啊，以色列啊，这些犹大人也是这样。
And the people of Judah are the same.
啊，他们只喜欢听到一些讨好他们、符合他们喜欢的话。
They only want to hear the things that make them feel good, the things that they want to hear.
那结果就在这种甜言蜜语当中，最后临到啊，最后面临了毁灭。
And in the midst of these sweet words they're listening to, they face their own destruction.
那所以圣经当中有神的温柔言辞。
So in the Bible, we see there are the gentle words of God.
啊，来给我们鼓励，来给我们安慰。
That encourage and comfort us.
啊，但是圣经当中也有神的严厉教导。
But the stern teachings of God are also in the Bible.
啊，使我们能够行正路，能够讨神的喜悦。
So that we can walk on the right path and we can be pleasing to God.
啊，所以不管是温柔的言辞，或者是严厉的教导。
So whether they are gentle words or stern teachings.
啊，属神的百姓都要放在心中。
The people who belong to God must put these in our hearts.
那所以在这里我们看到这些百姓遭灾的原因。
So here we see the reason why calamity comes upon this people.
啊，那我们再看回来耶利米书的十四章。
So let's turn back to Jeremiah chapter 14.
我们来看一看这些先知的问题。
Let's look at the problem with the prophets.
我们看耶利米书十四章。
Jeremiah chapter 14,
第十三节
verse 13.
我就说，爱主神啊，这些先知常对他们说，你们必不看见刀剑，不遭遇饥荒，神要在这地方赐你们长久平安。我们刚刚已经念过这一节。
And we just read this verse.
啊，我们是从百姓的角度来看这件事情。
But we looked at it from the perspective of the people.
啊，我们学到说啊，啊，这个啊，我们需要慎思明辨，听到的话要能够再去咀嚼思考。
And we learned that when we hear the words of the prophet, we have to ponder and consider what they're saying and think about what they're saying.
啊，我们也学到说，我们不要只喜欢听好听的话，只喜欢听啊这个温柔的道理。
And we also learned that.We should not only want to listen to the kind and good words, but not only the things that are pleasing to us.
那我们现在从另外一个角度，我们来看讲这些话的先知。
But let's look at this from another perspective. Let's look at it at the people who are speaking these words.
啊，这里讲说啊，先知告诉他们说，很平安，都没问题，你会兴，你会富足，你会兴盛。
Here we see the prophet say to the people that there will be peace, there will be prosperity.
那为什么这些工人要讲这些话呢？
And why do these workers want to say these type of words?
啊，是因为他们真正有从神那里得到讯息，才这样告诉百姓吗？
Is it because they truly received this message from, the God, from God and they wanted to tell the people?
还是因为他们知道这些就是百姓想听的话，讲这些你就会得到大家的喜悦。
Or are they saying these words because they know that this is what the people want to hear? So if they say these things, the people will like them.
那所以在这里我们看到这些先知。
So here we see these prophets.
其实这些先知已经失去他们的本色，也失去了他们存在的价值。
And here these prophets already lost their nature as a prophet and the reason of their existence.
啊，虽然他们仍然被称为先知。
Even though they are still called prophets.
那虽然在众人的眼中，他们还是得到尊重。
And in the eyes of the people, they are still respected.
啊，但是这些人在神面前已经失去了先知的职分，先知的本色。
But before God, these people have already lost their status as prophets and their essence as prophets.
啊，在人可能没有办法做判断。
Maybe in man's eyes, they cannot see.
啊，因为他从外表看你，看起来又虔诚，又又虔诚，又又刻苦。
Because outwardly, it looks like they are very devout and they are very earnest.
哦，好像啊，每天花很多时间啊，这个还有一些啊，这个很特殊的啊，这个仪式或者是一些很特殊的表现。
It seems like every day they spend a lot of time and doing these special ceremonies.
哦，在别人的眼中看来，好神秘，好超然，哦，好属灵。
And in the eyes of everyone else, they seem like they're very mysterious, very godly, and they're superior.
啊，讲实话，要让人觉得你很不一样，其实并不困难的。
But truthfully speaking, if you want other people to feel that you're different, it's not very hard.
啊，就讲一些玄而又玄的这个灵界啦，这个什么梦啦，这个讲一些啊啊这种啊让人觉得说哦。啊，这个好属灵，好神秘。你讲一讲，别人就觉得你很不一样啊。
You just need to talk about things that sound very mysterious, talk about dreams and things that are very deep, and people will say that's so spiritual.
啊，最好讲得非常的艰深，艰涩，困难，就是大家有听，通通没有懂，就觉得你第一名啊。
And you just have to make it as difficult, as complicated as you can.As long as nobody can understand what we are saying, then you'll become the best.
啊，所以啊，啊，这些先知，啊，这些先知，他们讲的，啊，就是让人觉得了不起，让人听得很舒服。
So what these prophets are saying are words that make people feel that they're very incredible and make people feel good.
啊，所以啊，这些百姓喜欢啊，走到哪里都有人支持接待。
And because the people love these prophets, so no matter where they go, they are supported and taken care of by the people.
那但是虽然啊，在人的眼中很尊贵，但是在神的面前却没有价值。
And even though they are viewed very honorably by the people, in God's eyes, they have no value.
那我们来看以赛亚书的第九章。
Let's look at Jeremiah chapter 9.
以赛亚书的九章第十四节
Jeremiah chapter 9 verse 14
十四节
verse 14
这里说因此主一日之间必从以色列剪除头跟尾宗枝与芦苇第十五节
verse 15
长老和尊贵人就是头以谎言教导人的先知就是尾十六节
16
因为引导这百姓的使他们走错了路被引导的都必败亡请念
Isaiah chapter 9 verses 14 to 16 Therefore the Lord will cut off head and tail from Israel palm branch and bulrush in one day. 15. The elder and honorable, he is the head. The prophet who teaches lies, he is the tail. 16. For the leaders of this people cause them to err, and those who are led by them are destroyed.
所以在这里一样，神在责备这些官长，这些尊贵人，这些先知。
And here, just the same, God is rebuking the people, the high officials, the elders, the prophets.
因为这些人用那美好的谎言来欺骗百姓，来得到人的喜悦。
Because these people use the beautiful lie to deceive the people and cause them to be uplifted by the people.
虽然看起来很成功，大家都喜欢你，高抬你。
And even though it seems that they're very successful, everybody loves them, everybody uplifts them.
但是到最后，你所带领的百姓却遭遇灭亡。
But in the end, the people who you are leading are led to destruction.
而你这个先知的职分，在神面前要遭到愤怒。
And your position as a prophet will incur the wrath of God.
所以今天我们说的是该说的话。
So today, we speak the words that we ought to say.
而不是人喜欢听的话。
We are not saying words that people enjoy listening to.
我们所教导的是圣经当中的道理。
What we are teaching are the teachings in the Bible.
而不是让人听的舒心的话语。
And not the teachings that make people feel good inside.
我们侍奉要最后要回答的对象是天上的神。
And the person that the one who we answer to in our service in the end is God in heaven.
而不是在追求得到众人的认同跟掌声。
And we are not pursuing the acknowledgement and praise of people.
我们看回来耶利米书的十四章。
Let's turn back to Jeremiah chapter 14.
十四章的第十八节。
Verse 18.
十八节。
18.
我若出往田间，就见有被刀杀；我若进入田内，我见有饥荒患病的。连先知带祭司在国中往来，也是毫无知识情念。
18. If I go out to the field, then behold, those slain with the sword. And if I enter the city, then behold, those sick from famine. Yes, both prophet and priest go about in a land they do not know.
在这里他后面有说，或者要翻译成不知道怎样才好，这样这个翻译比较好一点。
And in the Chinese version, there's a footnote saying in the end, it's saying that they are in a land where they don't know what to do.
这里讲的毫无知识，不是说先知祭司没读书不懂事。
And when it says the prophet and priest go about a land they do not know, it is not saying that the prophet and priest, didn't study and they don't know anything.
这里讲的是这些先知跟祭司走来走去也不知道要去哪里，也没有应当要前进的方向。
But it's saying that the prophet and the priest walk back and forth and they don't know where they should go, they don't know what direction to go in.
祭司是以色列人的是以色列人的属灵领袖。
The priest is the spiritual leader of the Israelites.
而先知是负责转达神的指示跟话语。
And the prophet is responsible for relaying the message and will of God.
所以他们的责任就是引导百姓走在神的正路上。
So their responsibility is to lead the people to walk on the right path of the Lord.
但是在这里我们却看到的是先知根本不知道自己要去哪里，就带着百姓到处乱绕。
But here we see that the prophet doesn't know where they're supposed to go, so they lead the people in a big circle.
那因为瞎眼领路，所以瞎眼领瞎眼就都掉到坑里。
And because the blind is leading the blind, they will both fall into a hole.
所以在这里我们看到先知的第二个问题。
Here we see the second problem of the prophets.
因为当先知想要讨好人，先知就变成了政客。
When the prophets seek to please people, they become politicians.
当先知不懂得引导人，他就成为瞎眼领路的。
When a prophet doesn't know how to lead people, they become the blind who is leading the blind.
所以在一个国家当中，当你有这样的百姓，当你有这样的领导者。
So in a country, when you have this type of people and this type of leader,
那结果就是走向死亡的深渊。
The result is that they walk towards the valley of death.
结果就是耶利米先知眼泪汪汪。
And in the end, Jeremiah could do nothing but weep.
这是一个令人悲哀的时代。
And this is a very tragic time.
也是今天给你我的一个警告跟提醒。
And this is also a warning for us today.
不论我们是这些百姓或者是先知祭司。
Whether we are the people or we are the prophets and priests.
从信徒或者是从侍奉这两个方向来看。
Whether we are looking ourselves as believers or as people who serve.
其实你跟我，我们都会扮演这两个角色。
And of course, you and I will play both of these roles.
我们也是信徒，我们也是先知祭司。
We are believers, we are also prophets and priests.
那我们就要以这些做警告，免得最后只剩眼泪汪汪而已。
And we need to heed these warnings, or in the end, we can only weep.
就像这里的尼西，在这里的耶利米为他们为他们感到难过。
Just like how Jeremiah here is very sad for the people.
最后只能求神怜悯，只能求神怜悯了。
And in the end, all he could do is ask God to have mercy.
那我们今天晚上一个简的分享就到这边。
And this concludes our sharing tonight.
我们一起来唱诗73首。
Let us sing hymn 73.